You got that bling bling, man.
You got a little ice. A little bit.
For the first time in program history, Valor College Prep are the state champions.
Good. There we go. I'm sorry. Fifth, I'm sorry, man.
Thank you.
Cam, pleasure to meet you,
brother. Nice to meet you, brother.
How you doing, man?
All right.
You got that bling bling, baby.
A little bit.
What is that for, by the way?
So this is our boys' soccer state championship from 2023.
Okay.
We are the first public school from Davidson County to ever win a state soccer championship. So pretty big deal. And only our fifth year of having varsity sports, we won us a state championship.
For me, I was here since middle school.
Right down the middle, Jad Rame with the fourth PK make out of five.
So I played in the middle school team from seventh grade until I graduated senior year high school.
Yep, same. We've both been playing together since the seventh grade.
Mitchell York got his gloves on it, pushed it over the crossbar, and the Wildcats are the state champions.
You know, at a little church field,
nice.
All the way up to Rose Park, where we play now.
So I hear that you are the gentleman, you know, that made this all happen in terms of the sports program. What inspired that decision?
I think just being able to provide opportunities and unique opportunities, I would say, for kids has always kind of been a passion for me. Being able to kind of give kids exposure to things that I wasn't exposed to as a kid has really just become my life's passion. Just being able to see the looks on our student athletes' faces today, it makes the job worth doing what I do every day.
Why soccer?
So soccer has just become unbelievably popular at our schools. Right. Our kids, if they're not on the teams, they're playing at recess. We have our varsity team sees over 100 kids try out for the team. Our middle school team see 150 kids try out for the team. So it's a really popular sport that has really just taken off in Nashville as a whole, but specifically for our three schools, soccer is just, it's king. Soccer's king here.
So you were two of the first guys involved in the athletics program. Tell me how well it's progressed since you first started to now.
I mean, it's night and day, to be honest. Like, it was really bad situation. We were an okay team at best. Then, like, as you know, Coach Hill came along and Coach Elkins came along, they kind of shaped the program to be, you know, one of the best ones in the state without having a pitch.
You know what's really impressive is that you achieved all of this without even having your own field, which is just a credit to you and the staff. How difficult was it between those moments to find fields to play on and those types of things?
I joke often, a lot of my work, probably about 35% of my work, is looking for fields. So whether it's calling schools, calling clubs, calling individual private fields. But the one thing I can say about our kids and our coaches, they just have a hard hat, lunch pail type of attitude. We kind of adopted this model, I'd say maybe 3 years ago. We're like, hey, okay, well, we don't have a field, so every game's gonna be a road game. So guess what? We're gonna make your field our home game,
yeah,
you know? So
yeah.
We travel well. Our student section, the den, really travels well and buys in. Our kids and our coaches, they don't make excuses. They just come to work every day. And like we're raising, you know, we want these young men and women to become leaders outside of this sport. So our goal is, we want 100% graduation rate for sure. The rings and the championships are beautiful and we love it. We're really excited about that. We think our future is really bright in all of our sports. But the goal for me and a win for me is when I see these kids walk across the stage or I get my alumni to come back like those two that you met today, when they come back and seeing them being successful in college, and that's the real win in this profession, when they grow up to be really good human beings.
What is it like in Nashville with soccer and how does that feel?
So a lot of our, especially our soccer kids, they play on like club teams, travel teams and things like that. So it has exploded for our school. That is what's grown the sport. Like, people want to be a part of that culture. They want to be a part of, like, they're getting to see these things. They're like, I want to be a part of this. So I wouldn't be surprised that, you know, after this, you know, we may have more kids that want to be involved.
Favorite Premier League team? You got to tell your boy. What are we talking? But who you got?
I'll go Liverpool for that.
My man.
Yeah.
Who you got?
I love watching Brighton play.
Brighton, they play beautiful style of football. And what about players? Which sorts of players have inspired you throughout your young careers, I should say?
I mean, for me, of course, I play center back, so I watched a lot of Van Dijk highlights right. before games and stuff, because right. he's just such a fantastic player. And I also like Mickey Van de Ven. I know, okay, he just came to the Prem, yeah. but I feel like I'm kind of a similar player. Like, I like to be on the ball, but I also like am a faster center back yeah. and stuff. So I think that's a player that I like. I think good I play vibes. Similar like.
Good vibes.
For me, as a goalie, I like to watch Jordan Pickford play. He's great, but with both feet, great shot stopper. In terms of players that I, you know, just like to watch, I love watching Ivan Toney at Brentford. Just a goal scorer, you know, and a great teammate. Coming back and like today, just to see how far the program has grown from a small middle school with only seventh and eighth graders playing sports. You know, we were the second class to graduate, and what we've already built in such a short time obviously gives the team currently a huge, you know, expectation. And I feel like Jad said, the expectation for them is to be consistent in winning and win another championship.
I think for us, like, we want to sustain, you know, Our culture here is like, we want a championship culture. So when you're talking about a championship culture is everything that we do. Like how we ride the bus, how we stay at hotels, how we leave a locker room after we play a game. Like, so I think we've hit a point now where we're like, this is our culture. Like, so winning is like the goal, but our goal is for them to win outside of the field, outside of the pitch.
Well, listen, credit to you and the staff and everybody involved that's made this incredible, you know, team and culture and program, you know, happen. You've done an amazing job for the community as well, which is really important. So I want to say hats off to you, because it's not easy to have a vision and make it all happen. But you managed to do it. Got yourself some bling. You know what I mean? Premier League have a gift for you. It's official balls right here, as you can see the Nike. Beautiful footballs. Yes, cherish these babies.
Thank you.
Don't let these
Thank
babies go to waste,
much.
Man.
Appreciate you.
Appreciate you, guys, and congratulations on a successful season. Wish you all the best in the future too. And also to Valor Prep. It's an amazing program what they're doing, and you know the football here is second to none. They did win the championship, so. Oh, you got me gassed up, man. God, you guys blinging, make sure you keep these safe, you know. We walking around, you know. This right here is special, for real.
Appreciate
it's beautiful.
That. Thank you.